It's the Big Apples of the Hawke's Bay.
The Big Apple project is 20 apples, giant apples, by 20 different artists, and they're all from Hawke's Bay, that are positioned around Hastings, Havelock North and Flaxmere.
In the biggest apple-growing region in Aotearoa. So an idea was planted 3 years ago to have big fiberglass apples as murals to celebrate the success of the industry. It took some time, but this year the local council provided some seed funding with other sponsors to allow locals to create a masterpiece. The Pasifika Senikau group were picked out of 47 artists to paint their very own apple canvas.
We thought that we named this apple the value of the Pacific apple, just to show the world that where the artists are from.
Aparosa is here on the recognised seasonal employer RSE scheme, with workmates from Samoa, Vanuatu, Solomon Islands and Fiji. The group used the opportunity to share their journey.
This one shows the humble journey that we took, leaving our home, our families, our parents behind, sacrificing to come over to here in New Zealand.
You can tell there's a real passion about it. They've got real heart and soul has gone into what they've made, so quite extraordinary and humbling.
And when comparing apples to apples, the Pacific one stands out. It features icons that connects to home, such as the hibiscus flower, the kava bowl wrapped together with a tapa cloth backdrop.
It took us 3 weeks of working hard, persevering through the night, and so many hours, and we were able to come up with this beautiful art of work.
The workers turned artists drew inspiration from the apple orchards of RJ Flowers, a local family business that's grown fruit here since 1906.
We have an incredible relationship with our boys. I call them our boys. I mean, obviously, they've got a family at home, but they've become part of our family. The last few years have been a huge challenge for everyone, and the respect I have for what sacrifices they've put out there have been huge, you know, and it's all in aid of thinking of others.
Here, they're more like family rather than employees. In 2016, John and his team fundraised to help to rebuild homes in Fiji impacted by Cyclone Winston. So it's a close-knit community. Aparosa's now into his eighth season, having arrived as a farmhand. He's now in a managerial role.
RSE is not something just to come to New Zealand or here in Knox Bay and your money and go back to your country. There's a lot of things that sort of that show us that we are part of this community.
His wife and two young kids back home in Fiji can enjoy the fruits of his labour.
I've done a lot of things. Some of those things I will not be able to accomplish back home. Extend the house, build a more cyclone-resistant house. And as now my kids are going to school, I'm also supporting them on their education.
He will return home this month after staying on a little longer due to the COVID-19 lockdown. He goes but leaves behind a big legacy.
Unity is possible, and things can be accomplished if we all work together in unity.
Now, in case you're wondering, the apples will be up for sale at a public auction on the 26th of October during the Hawke's Bay Arts Festival.
It's the apples now making sweet memories.